Hey guys, it's Blake, and we officially know the Undisputed Universal Championship match for the Royal Rumble. No, it's not a one-on-one match. It is a Fatal-4-Way match. Roman Reigns defends against Randy Orton, AJ Styles, LA Knight. How could this match unfold? We may think we know the winner, but how do we get there? Let's talk about it here on Wrestling Reaction. All right, so the Royal Rumble 4-Way, as we said, was officially put in place on SmackDown after you had the triple threat match that was supposed to determine who would face Roman Reigns at Royal Rumble. Kind of broke down because the bloodline came out and you had all of that kind of fallout from there, which led to the 4-Way match being announced. And I think, again, a lot of people, based on some reports that came out before SmackDown, expected this and sort of figured this was the route they were going. But now that we have the match, the question is, how does this thing unfold? Let's start at the beginning, okay? And I'd say if you're betting on this, I'd say there's a really good chance that Roman Reigns is going to retain his Undisputed Universal Championship to set up a showdown with his next opponent, which could it be The Rock? Could it be Cody Rhodes? We did talk about that on another video here on Wrestling Reaction, so be sure, hit that subscribe button, go back and watch that video. We did that a couple days ago after The Rock made his return on Raw. But as for this match, why did they go this route? Well, I think there were a lot of people that thought, and I think there are two probably, you know, likely options here. For starters, you know, if it's Roman Reigns versus Randy Orton, which seemed like the initial direction, the thing was, you probably did not want to beat Randy Orton this quickly after his return, because remember, Orton's been back less than 2 months now. And, you know, getting one of the better reactions on the show for sure. And so maybe they didn't want to go to this that quickly. Although you could also, you know, ask the question, well, are they ever going to be able to get to this match if Reigns loses the title, you know, at WrestleMania to whoever that is, which I think, again, the most likely option would be Cody Rhodes there. But, you know, how does that unfold, right? Like, do they actually get to the Roman Reigns, Randy Orton title program match? Maybe they don't. Maybe it's a feud they save. That doesn't involve a title, but I can see why they were not going to put Orton in that position right away to lose a match. I would say cleanly, but you could have done the interference route, which we've seen in many other Roman Reigns matches during this title reign. But the other one that I saw some people pointing out, which I think also makes sense, is, you know, maybe Orton's just still not ready for that one-on-one high-profile match that this would be. Physically, and maybe that is something where, you know, you bring him back kind of in, you know, the multi-man, you know, War Games match, then you have him set up here for this Fatal 4-Way. Now, of course, he's had some one-on-one matches, but again, this is a different expectation when you're having a one-on-one match on Raw versus having a one-on-one match in a main event, you know, Royal Rumble show. Like, that is just a much different expectation. And so I tend to think, you know, that maybe there's a little bit of both involved in that. Wouldn't surprise me at all. It just seems like it makes sense on both points. So that was probably why you didn't get the direction here that they were going. Now, I will say, before we even get to the next two competitors, there have been people wondering, and even in some cases, I think making a prediction, that the reason they did this, a Fatal 4-Way, is so that Roman Reigns does not have to get pinned to lose his title. Now, I think that would be the wrong move, to have Roman Reigns lose his championship. And quite honestly, I think the percentage of that happening is about 1%, maybe less than 1%. And some of you may say there is a 0% chance that happens. Let me know in the comments what you think that percentage is. But I just don't see it, because, again, you're setting up Roman Reigns to face either The Rock or Cody Rhodes, or maybe both, on the road to WrestleMania or at WrestleMania. And so I can't imagine Roman Reigns losing this long run, this, you know, historic title reign ends with him not getting pinned in a Fatal 4-Way match at the Royal Rumble. I just don't think that was ever going to be the setting that this would happen. And if they do that, boy, there is going to be some backlash. That maybe not from some people who want to see Reigns lose a title, but there's going to be some backlash from a story standpoint, because, you know, if Reigns is losing the title here, which, like I said, is a less than 1% chance, he would lose it to Orton, would be my thing. But, and then I know people have set up the, well, you can then have Cody finish the story against Randy Orton. I just don't see that making any sense. You've played up Roman Reigns and Cody Rhodes for a year plus now, all of this has led to that eventual match against them, you know, the rematch. And yes, The Rock has kind of thrown a wrench into things, depending on how they go about it. But I just do not see a scenario here where Roman Reigns loses this championship at all. Like, pinned or not pinned, he's not losing the championship at the Royal Rumble. I would be absolutely stunned if they go this route. So, yeah, I don't think that's happening. I don't think Randy Orton's walking out as the Undisputed Universal Champion and going on to face Cody Rhodes at WrestleMania, because I think there is way more, you know, kind of storyline plot points you can get to with Cody Rhodes and Randy Orton, but not now. You don't want to rush this thing for 2 months, because this is something that could carry you for, you know, 6 months or something. Like, realistically, this could carry you through the summer and all of that, if you wanted to go the direction of once Cody eventually wins the title, putting him in something with Orton would just make too much sense at that point. I don't think Cody finishing the story against Randy Orton, who has a 2 month title reign, is going to be something that's going to make anyone happy, probably in that scenario. So, all right. So that, of course, leaves AJ Styles and LA Knight. And this is where you get into kind of, how does this match unfold? Seemingly, I feel like logic would tell you that one of these two guys is getting pinned. I don't think it's going to be Orton for all the reasons we just mentioned. It's not going to be Reigns for all the reasons we just mentioned. So it's either going to be AJ Styles or LA Knight. And maybe that comes, again, via interference from whoever, right? Take your pick. It could be Solo Sikoa. It could be Jimmy Uso. It could be Jey Uso getting involved somehow, trying to go after Reigns. Like, there are so many options you could go to here. You know, again, you've got maybe The Rock. Maybe there's other aspects that you could throw into the mix here. But all of this is going to, I think, lead to either AJ Styles or LA Knight getting pinned. And I think that's probably the better question here. Not who's going to win the match, who's going to take the pin. And I would think, you know, again, you kind of look at all these different characters, and it does kind of feel like a situation where you don't really want to beat anyone here. And that's why you do the Fatal 4-Way. But I would think too that AJ Styles just came back, you know, as part of kind of this revamped character. LA Knight, I think, as some people were also talking about, which I think makes sense. You really don't want to put LA Knight in the Royal Rumble, because if you do that, then, you know, you think about the, you know, ovation that he's going to get and the disappointment if he doesn't win, because again, he's one of the most overstars on the roster. And so, you know, you don't want to kind of put him in there with a Cody Rhodes, a CM Punk and all that. And you're kind of splitting perhaps, you know, what the fans really want. And because again, LA Knight is so over at this point that there are a lot of people that would love to see him win the Royal Rumble. But it's probably not going to happen. And so you keep him out of the match to maybe prevent that. I understand that point. That makes a lot of sense. So I feel like AJ Styles is the one that probably seems like the most likely candidate to take the pin here. Even though, again, he just came back too, and you know, the characters kind of had a little bit of an overhaul and all that. But I just tend to think that that's probably the most likely option, because I really do think you just have to rank this in terms of, if you're looking at it from WWE's perspective, who are the guys that you want to beat the least? And even if you don't want to beat any of these guys, you know, Reigns is number one, Orton's number two, in my opinion, or maybe LA Knight. But they're two and three in whatever order. And then I think it's Styles. You know, again, I'm a big AJ Styles fan, but I just think if you're looking at the way WWE has pushed all of these guys in the Triple H era, which we've not seen a lot of that with Orton, but we know that Triple H is not just going to throw Orton out there and let him get pinned. If you wanted to do that, they could have done the one-on-one match, period. So I feel like that is the most likely option here, is AJ Styles in some way, shape, or form takes the pin. But I do think that makes this match appealing. Whereas if you did do Randy Orton versus Roman Reigns, it feels pretty predictable. You know, I think everyone knows at that point that Roman Reigns is walking out as the champion. But with this, even if you have a pretty strong feeling that Reigns is going to walk out as the champion, you don't exactly know how they're going to get there, because there's a lot more dynamics in play. It's not just one-on-one. There's not just one other guy in there to where you can say, all right, well, someone's going to interfere, that's the match. You've got you know, all the different dynamics between these four guys. You know, there's history between Roman and AJ. There's history between Roman and LA Knight. There's now, you know, the history between Roman and Orton. Like, again, the stuff in the past, plus what's kind of led to this match here at this point. So, yeah, I think that makes this match more unpredictable in terms of how it plays out. Maybe not from the standpoint of who wins, but I think there's a lot more kind of possible scenarios in play here. It does make this a more intriguing match, potentially. Maybe not a better match overall. You know, just again, because the one-on-one dynamic, you can do a lot with that. But you can also do a lot here with this Fatal 4-Way. So I'm curious to see how this thing goes, I will make my prediction now. Roman Reigns is going to walk out as the Undisputed Universal Champion. But I'd be lying if I said I know exactly how they're going to get there, because I think there's a lot of fun options on the table. And I'd love to hear what you guys think about this Fatal 4-Way match for the Undisputed Universal Championship at the Royal Rumble. Roman Reigns versus Randy Orton versus LA Knight versus AJ Styles. Let me know in the comments what you think about this match, who interferes, who takes the pin, all that good stuff. And again, be sure to hit that subscribe button. Always appreciate you guys watching. Check out all the other videos on the channel here as we head towards the Royal Rumble. And so I appreciate you watching, and we'll talk to you again here soon at Wrestling Reaction.